Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today is Graphic Design Interview Questions and Answers Part 5. And if you want to know what questions we're going to ask in this video, those are found in the description, so check it out. All right, so let's get started. Question number one.
How do you respond when a client gives you harsh feedback or criticism?
Okay, of course I've had this happen a lot of times, and I think really the main thing to do is to stay professional. So I usually talk to the client and say something like, so let's go over what it is that you don't like about the design, and then I can try to improve it, and we can bounce ideas off each other, and we'll go from there. So sometimes it could just be like the colors or something really simple that the client doesn't like. And so I think keeping the lines of communication open and also just being really professional, not getting mad or anything like that is the best way to go about it. So what is the interviewer looking for with this question? I think the interviewer is looking for your response to criticism. A lot of people get frustrated and angry, or they just shut down completely. And the interviewer wants to know that you're not going to do that. So I think it's a good idea to say you want to keep communication lines open, you want to stay professional. Those things are really important. Number two.
Describe a time when you worked with another team on a design project.
Well, I collaborate with other departments on almost every project I do, but if you're looking for one specifically, there was one recently where we had multiple billboards and multiple magazine ads that all had to have the same look and feel and the same type of content. So at the very beginning, I sat down with my team and also the other teams, and we just had a big brainstorming session. So we collaborated in that way. We worked together and we bounced ideas off each other. And then as the project went on, I sat down with the content team and other teams as needed to really hash out those fine details. I think that's the best way to get the best possible final product for the client, is to be collaborative with all team members involved. So what is the interviewer looking for with this question? When an interviewer asks you to describe a time that you did something, make sure you answer that part of the question. A lot of people will just say, oh, well, I always do it this way, but they want to know about a specific instance in your history that you did the thing. So make sure you answer that part of the question. And then, of course, with this question, they just want to see how you work with other teams and work together with your own team. So be sure to let them know that you get along with everybody and you communicate well with others. Number three.
How would you define color theory? And why is it important in graphic design?
Color theory is so important. Different color combinations can really affect a viewer. The color red can come across as really harsh. It can cause the viewer to think of blood and anger and that kind of thing. So you have to be really careful when you apply it to design. I think color is really important because it can either draw people in or it can push them away. So you have to think about that kind of thing when you're designing. So what is the interviewer looking for? With this question, I think the interviewer just wants to know if you understand color theory. I see it as sort of a testing you question. For a lot of us, color theory is intuitive. It's not something we really sat down and learned about. We didn't have a class on color theory in college, at least I didn't. I think it's just one of those things that they want to know that you have kind of an understanding of. Question number four.
How do you measure your design success?
I measure design success in a few different ways. Number one, the client is happy with the design. And then number two, is it fulfilling its purpose? So maybe the point was to drive more traffic to a website or get the client's customers to take an action. And a lot of times as designers, we don't get to know that. So I really try to make an effort to get these kind of metrics so I can kind of get a grasp on how well my campaign did. So what is the interviewer looking for? With this question, I think the interviewer actually wants to know what metric you use as a designer, because it's something that is really hard for us as designers and marketers to actually know if what we did caused the action or reaction we're looking for. So they might just be curious. Question number five.
I was wondering, have you done annual reports? Because we're going to need annual reports here at the firm. I was just wondering.
Actually, I haven't done any annual reports. I've done a lot of multi-page brochures and also multi-page white papers. And I think there's a lot of crossover there with annual reports. So I don't really think designing annual reports would be outside my comfort zone at all. It's really similar to a lot of other things I've done. So what is the interviewer looking for? With this question, the interviewer wants to know if you are able to do the thing that they do a lot of. Probably in this scenario, the interviewer's company makes a lot of annual reports, and they want to know if you have experience with that. So if you do have experience, of course, absolutely tell them all the experience you have, but sometimes you won't have experience with that one certain thing. In that case, try to just tie it into other things you've done in the past that are very similar to that kind of project. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click the like button. And if you have any suggestions for videos that you'd like me to make or topics you'd like me to cover, please leave those in the comments section below. And I will see you next Thursday. Thank you.